is older, older than the trees, younger than the mountains, growing like a breeze. Country roads, take me home to the place.
During the Great Depression, farmers were negatively affected the most because they had to sell their farms, sharecroppers were kicked off their land, and the Dust Bowl destroyed their farms.
Not only did the farmers have to deal with the economic crash, they also had to deal with a geographical disaster in which they could not control.
Farmers were one of the most prosperous groups in the early 1900s, as the wheat business was booming and it was looking to be the best harvest ever. World War I became a key source of income for them, as they could sell their crops to the Allies. However, this all changed during the Great Depression.
All hope farmers had for a better future was now lost, and just putting a roof over their heads was the most they were thinking about.
Farmers were negatively affected in many ways, such as them having to sell their farms. The reason farmers had to sell their farms was overall because of a lack of money. When unemployment was high during the Great Depression, consumers buying crops was lessened.
Due to this, farms couldn't sell as much of their goods to the people. When this happened, farmers couldn't pay their mortgage. Now, many farmers were in debt, and the only way to make money was to sell their farms.
However, the farmers ended up selling their farms for less than they bought them. This was because the farms' property values sunk when the economy went into recession, and when the dust covered the once fertile lands.
Many farmers were in an even worse situation, and couldn't sell their farms. They ended up losing their land to foreclosure, which is a legal process that allows a lender to take over the property as help the borrower buy. Effects of foreclosure on farmers were them losing their homes, livelihoods, and all invested money.
Unlike most jobs, farmers owned where they worked. This meant that when they lost their farms, they were in theory unemployed. For example, factory workers did not own the factory they worked in, so if it shut down, they could probably go work at another one.
Another impact of the Great Depression on farmers was more directed towards tenant farmers and sharecroppers. They were actually affected the worst amount. This is because these farmers could not afford to buy land regardless of their race.
These groups instead borrowed money from their owner to purchase seeds and other supplies. However, the sharecroppers did not make enough money selling crops to cover their debts.
This was because the annual income per person plummeted. It went from $239 in 1929 to $117 in 1933 due to the stock market crashes. Since sharecroppers were making so little money, they couldn't pay rent to the people that owned the land they farmed on, so they were fired.
The Dust Bowl destroyed farms all across the Midwest and lasted for several years. In 1931, many farmers were hopeful for a good harvest season since crop productions were on an all-time high and wheat prices had skyrocketed. However, the good harvest never arrived, but instead a drought that had killed all of the crops.
Winds and dust storms started to sweep through the Great Plains, which led to the Dust Bowl, one of the worst parts of the Great Depression. As farmers became more enraged by the terrible weather conditions, the dust storms started to get worse.
Soon the storms were turning to black blizzards, which were so bad that they picked up tons of soil, making visibility near impossible. The dust spread across millions of acres of farmland, in states like Texas and New Mexico, making those lands uninhabitable for farmland.
In 1934, there was an astonishing 38 dust storms in the Great Plains. The Great Plains were now experiencing desertification, which means the land was dry and desert-like. This meant farmers could no longer grow their crops and make a profit.
Droughts are one of the causes of desertification because they dried out the ground. Another reason was the unhealthy farming habits practiced by farmers who destroyed the soil. These bad practices started because of World War I.
During the war, the government made farmers grow as much wheat as possible to sell to the Allies. However, after the war, crop prices dropped, so farmers increased their harvests to get more money. They did this by growing and planting crops on every piece of land and over-harvesting.
This led to the soil becoming depleted of nutrients. Over time, farms basically stripped the land of its drought-resistant vegetation. As a result, winds could pick up all the soil the farmers needed to grow and spread them across acres of land.
The government tried to help the loss of all this valuable soil by enacting the Soil Conservation Service, thus promoting farming methods that would keep healthy soil for many years. They also helped reduce wind from blowing over the Great Plains.
Overall, farmers were negatively affected during the Great Depression because they had suffered major economic hardships as well as climate catastrophe. Their land was taken away or sold for little value due to the farmers' debt. This, along with the Dust Bowl, made it almost impossible for farmers to prosper in the Great Depression.